Florida is developing new standards for managing lithium-ion battery fires. State Fire Marshal Jimmy Patrona says new rules are needed because electric vehicles and other devices like e-scooters and e-bikes are becoming more common.
Our Capitol Bureau reporter Cody Butler tells us how the state is trying to protect our first responders.
You don't have to go too far to find electric vehicles or scooters across Florida. When they catch fire, they're almost impossible to put out.
The danger is known, and it is real, and now is the time to act.
Thursday, the Department of Financial Services began making rules to develop standards for managing lithium-ion battery fires. State Fire Marshal Jimmy Patrona says having standards for handling these fires is critical for Florida. That's because electric vehicles can catch fire shortly after a hurricane.
These heavily mineralized saltwater grade bridges, all these batteries, they short out. And when they short out, they create a cascade effect.
Patrona says 20 EVs caught fire after Hurricane Ian in 2022. The Florida Professional Firefighters president says firefighter safety needs to be looked at more than just putting out these fires.
Beyond the challenge of just simply trying to extinguish these types of fires, there's also another danger that sometimes is overlooked that deals with the harmful and cancer-causing off gases produced during a lithium battery fire incident.
In addition to creating state rules, Patronus is encouraging Congress to approve federal rules for lithium batteries. It would increase protections for firefighters.
We've got to be sensitive to where the problems lie that have not been yet fully discovered or factored of how to deal with this technology.
It could take 9 months to a year to develop state standards. In Tallahassee, Cody Butler, WCTV Eyewitness News.
And the state fire marshal's office will also be hosting training for first responders to discuss safe handling and response techniques.